Hi, I'm Veronica Vance. Coming up, we hit the links at the Fieldstone Golf Course, shop the massive indoor Great Lakes Art Fair, and then we give you the lowdown on upcoming sporting events in the D, so stay tuned.
Production funding for this program was made possible by the Detroit Metro Convention and Visitors Bureau, driving tourism growth in Metro Detroit since 1896. More information is available at visitdetroit.com.
I'm in Auburn Hills at the Fieldstone Golf Club, where golf pro Gordon Marmion is going to show us a few of his favorite holes. Golf pro Gordon, this is sort of your course, the Fieldstone Golf Club.
Yes, Fieldstone Golf Club, opened in 1998. We've been around for quite a number of years. It's a tough golf course. You have to play your ball from point A to point B to score well out here. Mm-hmm. Not deceiving by any means and not unforgiving. Plenty of room to hit it off the tee and into the wider fairways, mm-hmm. but it does narrow up as we approach the greens. And of course, there's multiple tee boxes to suit your right. level of play. It's par 72, 18-hole golf course mm-hmm. designed by Arthur Hills in 1998, as I discussed earlier. Yeah. What we do is host a lot of tournaments, mm-hmm. leagues, outings. It's probably one of the finest municipal golf courses in Michigan, ranked among the top three in Detroit metropolitan area out of 200 golf courses.
And you've got a restaurant and a retail shop, pro shop?
Yep, golf shop, mainly apparel. We don't do a lot of equipment out of the golf shop. The Vista Grill is our restaurant. We seat approximately 72 in the grill room.
Okay.
We have a boardroom that people utilize for private meetings that seats about 24.
Oh, nice.
Outdoor patio, we get a ton of lunch business on a daily basis. And then our larger golf functions go on the in our outdoor veranda that seats up to 160.
And so what would you say, Gordon, are some of your favorite holes if you had to pick?
We're sitting here on number 8, very challenging.
Let's see how you fare today.
Let's give it a shot, see if I can put one on the green.
So what are you doing to prepare for this? 227 yards. Par 3.
You're not filming all this. You're killing me.
I'm fully confident in it.
Now, 227, this is what we call our professional tee out at Fieldstone. I wouldn't recommend these tee boxes for anybody over a 4 handicap. So it slopes at 142 from the gold tees, just up in front of us about 20 yards. Just put a good move on it.
So this is where you're?
Yes. Now I missed my shot off the tee to the right. But
you're a good trooper too, because you're not moving the ball. This is really where it landed.
Yes, we'll play the ball as it lies. But very typical what you'll find out at Fieldstone when you miss a green.
Mm-hmm.
It will work your short game to death. I've got to get it up and over, get it close to that pin, and get a one putt in here.
I'm back out of the way.
Yes, you're doing fine. I haven't hit one dead right in a few years. Not as close as I thought I'd get, but still working.
Wow, look at that. Oh, so close.
So fit for no warm-up on one of the toughest par threes in Oakland County.
So this is number 9?
Yes.
How many yards?
We're at 414 yards from the professional tee.
Okay. Wow, and so this is a par 5?
Par 4. I'm just
going to
find those striped lines, that shortcut fairway out there. Stay away from the bunkers, stay away from the long heather.
Mm-hmm.
Just put one right down the middle and make our job very easy.
Okay, and I'll be your cheerleader over here on the side.
Thank you so much. I'm going to need it today.
Oh, nice.
I'm just going to try to find the middle of this green. This fairway is going to slant me a little right. The wind's going to feed a little bit right, so I hope all those things work into my favor. I've got about 130 to get to the center of the green here. Missed that one a little. Missed my approach shot. Hit a little thin, a little bit right. Not too much recovery, though.
Nope, I'm going to zip my lip and let you do your thing.
Most of the game is learning how to manage our misses, and that's what I'm trying to do today. Manage some of my missed shots so we don't have to score too high. So a little chip and run, back in my stance, hands forward, weight forward.
in, it should just bounce out and run to the hole. Nice, nice and easy here.
Wow. Oh, you were gonna get it.
It was close.
Inside left edge this time. Should be nice and easy.
Ah.
One par, one bogey. Typical towards Fieldstone Golf Course. It will get you when you are going to sleep out here. We're on number 9. We're just gonna make the turn, head off to number 10. There's a quick turn drive. You can see how we line up our carts for outings, for leagues. Very busy facility.
Yeah.
We hope to have you out here soon.
All right, well, Gordon, it's been fun.
Pleasure.
Thank
Absolute
you.
Pleasure.
And he's
Thank
the man
so
out here at Fieldstone Golf Club in Auburn Hills. You want to get lessons? Get them from the pro here. I think I'll be back for lessons.
We had a great time today. Thank you so much.
Happens every spring and every fall. If you come in the fall, you can get in a little early Christmas shopping, and we're going to show you around some of their great exhibits.
This is our gallery entrance. It's an area where we're allowed to take the many of the artists and exhibitors and put their works on display, mm-hmm. and create kind of an ambiance for the people to come in. And this is something that, you know, we do, that we invest in for this show, that we promote in-house, and really think it's an important part of the theme.
Now, this is one that happens, what, twice a year?
Twice a year, in the spring and the fall, you know, depending on the dates.
About how many artists do we have?
There's about 180 booths with about 150 different artists.
Wow, that's a big, big art show.
It is, but we're very concerned about quality, so we have a waiting list even of artists to participate,
really?
So we're trying to keep our quality in place and have a good experience for the people to come as well as for the artists.
Now, you mentioned quality, too. It's also a juried show, correct?
Absolutely. They take the artwork and they examine it and all the information from the artists, and then we categorize it and then select a very few.
So what have we got? A lot of local, a lot of national artists? What's kind
there
of
is
field?
Both, but because it's called the Great Lakes Art Fair, we really wanted to concentrate on artists from our region.
Cool. Can we go take a look
Absolutely.
At some of that?
Absolutely.
We've got like a large selection of
Absolutely.
Art.
Absolutely. I mean, all the categories are here. You know, of course, fine jewelry, ceramics, multimedia, paintings, oils. We have pottery works going on.
So there's a lot of great art, but this really caught my eye here.
Yep, this is one of the more popular features of the show.
Really?
This is Vision Spa Salon, and they actually are local here in Novi with their permanent facility. But they come into the show and actually set up a full-blown spa and salon.
So
you can get an Asiatsu, I think it's called, massage here.
Wow.
They actually have treatment rooms in the back for pedicures, facials.
People formations. Come here and get pedicures and
absolutely.
Manicures?
Absolutely.
Really?
People make appointments, actually, from the floor, come in, and do their shopping, get their treatments, eat in our wonderful cafe, and enjoy the day.
So this is the hooking station, huh?
That's right. Our show has our own hooker. Ann Bond, who is a part of Vision Spa Salon, actually does these wonderful, ornate rugs, and they are called hookers.
Beautiful.
And this is her number one student.
These are all handmade?
All handmade, and the fabrics are all dyed. Ann has actually gone to the point now where she has created her own dye books and has become an instructor. She's taken this to a new level.
Okay, something's calling my name here. It smells really good. What is this?
Well, this is a cafe operation that we put together especially for this event. Our chefs and folks here at Epic Catering, who does all of our food service in our Diamond Center, because of the art and the level of the event, we do a whole hand-tossed pasta station, fresh baked paninis, fresh salad bar, and things like that. So, again, you can make a whole day of it.
So it's a very upscale concession.
We're trying to do that, but at the same time, keep a very, very good price point on things.
Mm-hmm.
Keep it very affordable, but very fresh.
Wow.
The art of food.
The art of food, very well put.
Exactly.
Back here, what is this? What do you call the specialty row?
Specialty foods areas and specialty items where you can get gourmet hot chocolates and lemonades, or gourmet candies and things like that.
All very gourmet and upscale and keeping with the whole theme of things.
Absolutely.
So it is a good family event.
Oh, absolutely. And one of the greatest things about it, too, is what we call Generation Next. It is where we've actually gotten all kinds of participation from local school systems, elementary school all the way up to high school, and like I said, we have Cranbrook and the like here as well, too, with all of their student art on display.
The aspiring artists who may be exhibiting here one day.
Absolutely.
You don't even know, right?
Homegrown artists right here in Detroit. Absolutely.
Great. Well, I want to thank you, Blair,
thank you
for showing me around. I'm going to take a look at some of the exhibits on my own, okay?
Great. Thank you very much.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
It.
Can you believe that these are watercolor paintings? They look so realistic. I love this booth. They've got wonderful photographs, and it takes me back to a special place. Well, being in the Motor City, your art certainly caught my eye. Now, you're a local guy, too, aren't you?
Yes, Farmington Hills.
And what's your inspiration for your art?
I absolutely love automobiles, and I love to show parts of a car that people don't realize. They walk up and look at a whole car. They don't realize that that whole car is composed of a lot of wonderful little areas. And so I like to focus in on that on a lot of my paintings.
Yeah.
And I try to show how much beauty there is in just the front end of a Pontiac, which at the time was just a medium range car.
These skies are made out of actual bamboo. The tree is broken down into shavings and turns into a fabric, and she actually makes skies out of a bamboo tree. Can you believe it? Isn't this guy cool? It's a motorcycle gas tank. Spoons for eyes, playing the sax. Pretty neat. Ooh, we got wrenches for legs. So creative. Well, so Carl, you're not only an artist here, but you're also an author.
Yes.
You've got some best-selling books here, correct?
Well, we've actually got three in a series. Our first one that we did was called Stranger in the Woods, and it's about the deer and birds reacting to a snowman that appears in their woods after a winter storm. This was done at Kensington Park. It made the number one on the New York Times bestsellers list, and seven out of the last 10 years it's been in the top four at Christmas on the New York Times bestsellers list. We've done three other movies now. We did a movie for Lost in the Woods, which won the Wild Screen Hand Award for Best Children's Nature Movie in the World. This is the movie right here. It's called Lost in the Woods.
You know what's really caught my eye? What's unique about these is that they're children's books, but they're photographs. And like you say, Kensington is where you took a lot of these.
Yeah, I mean
like there was local. Tying in with the whole theme of the Great Lakes Art Fair, we've got the Art of Food, where there's executive chefs from some of the top-tiered restaurants in the area giving live cooking demonstrations. And at the end, you get to sample the food. They even do live demonstrations at a lot of the artists' booths. So you hand-carved all of these birds?
Yes.
That is amazing. Oh, my goodness. Well, Sean, you've got gorgeous, gorgeous art pieces here.
Well, these are, I call them landscape series vases, and they're kind of based on, well, obviously different gardens and things like this, my love of flowers. The technique is an Italian technique, which is called millefiori, and which is 1,000 flowers. I have kind of changed it and Americanized it
to
my own technique here.
They even have clothes and accessories here. These are beautiful pieces of jewelry, handmade out of Swarovski crystals, and they're just gorgeous. I think I'm leaning towards these. I'm gonna try the peanut butter hot chocolate. Doesn't that sound scrumptious? Ooh, that's yummy. Ooh, it tastes just like a Reese's peanut butter cup. Well, I just can't resist. My little ones are gonna love these books. One of each. Well, I've got my personalized book signed by the actual author, and this has just turned out to be a fantastic show, and just when you think you've seen them all, you really haven't. There are plenty of things to see and do in Metro Detroit this month, and our calendar of events is up next to point you in the right direction.
The Rhythmic Extravaganza Stomp comes to the Macomb Center, and the Rensen will be abuzz with the Motor City Tattoo Expo. Golf season kicks off at the country's largest golf show, and the Fly Fishing Expo will teach you everything about the sport. Spring forward for Corktown's St. Patrick's Day Parade. Then the Illusionists team up with Warhouse for Circus 1903. Get ready for summer on the lake at the Novi Boat Show, then enjoy an intimate tribute to piano men Billy Joel and Elton John. Dinosaurs are unleashed at Cobo Center, then the rock musical Rent celebrates its 20th anniversary. Follow your heart to the Palace for Disney on Ice, and Dirty Dancing, the classic story on stage, premieres at the Fox. Action and adrenaline take center field for the AMA Supercross, then Sisters Easter Catechism is back for answers and laughs. To learn of any changes, log on to visitdetroit.com or call 1-800-DETROIT.
I'm Melissa. I'm from Livonia. I found a lot of great energy and excitement in the arts community going on in the city right now. The DIA and MOCAD.
There's no mistaking it. Detroit is one of the greatest sports towns in the country. From the young to the not so young, Detroiters love to watch and play all year long. And the great thing about the D is that we've got it all, from professionals to college and amazing amateur events throughout the year. And we're fortunate enough to have a premier venue that hosts many of these events. It's the USA Hockey Arena right here in Plymouth. Well, Pete, this is such an impressive arena. Tell me about the USA Hockey Arena.
Well, when it was built in 1996, it was built by Peter Karmanos, who owned the Plymouth Whalers at the time,
right,
and was the founder of the Copyware Youth Program. The Plymouth Whalers played here until 2015, when they were sold and moved to Flint. USA Hockey and the National Team Development Program came here. They've done a fabulous job renovating and upgrading everything over the last couple of years.
And you get some big events in here, right? I mean, your international hockey teams are coming here, correct?
That's right. The National Team Development Program, there's two teams, a U17 and U18. That's those teams are the regular tenants here, and they play in the United States Hockey League. But one of the unique things about USA Hockey and the National Team Development Program is they bring in international tournaments. The National Junior Evaluation Camp, which is in August, and five teams from around the world come here and train for the national for what's called the World Junior Championships in December. And almost every player on all of the teams is either an National Hockey League draft pick or is up for the upcoming NHL draft.
That's
so
exciting.
In the summertime, you'll see 30 teams, NHL teams here with 200 scouts watching all these teams. So the unique thing, like I say, is the international events bring something new and fresh and different to the Detroit area that you don't see anywhere else.
And then, of course, you also have, you're starting your the young ones here too. You've got what, Learn to Skate programs,
right,
youth hockey leagues for the younger kids as well.
One of the cool things that has remained in this building is a very busy, productive, and fun for kids and their parents. Learn to skate, learn to play hockey, all kinds of youth activities. A typical weekend, say from a Friday afternoon to a Sunday night, we might have 40 to 50 different events here. Right. There's something for everybody and something for all families in the D.
All right, well, thank you so much, Pete.
My pleasure.
Detroit has a tremendous lineup of sporting events, and heading into the spring is an especially exciting time for sports in the D. The Pistons and the Red Wings are still playing and hopefully heading into the playoffs. And then there's the Tigers, one of the greatest franchises in the history of baseball. And here in the D, Tiger Opening Day is a citywide holiday. It usually takes place somewhere around the first week of April, and it's an event you don't want to miss. Spring also ushers in a host of other sporting events, and I'm going to show you what's in store for all you sports fans from now through the end of August, like an event that happens right here at the USA Hockey Arena in Plymouth. Starting March 31st through April 7th, the 2017 International Ice Hockey Federation Women's World Championship takes place, and this year's tournament features Team USA competing for their fourth straight gold medal. Now, if you want more female hockey, the Toyota USA Girls Tier 1, Tier 2, and Women's National Championship skates into town. You can catch all this action at two locations, either the Suburban Ice of Rochester Macomb or the Troy Sports Center, and it all happens April 6th through the 10th. Also in Detroit, from June 2nd to the 4th, one of the greatest motorsport racing competitions hits the streets. The Chevrolet Detroit Belle Isle Grand Prix roars all weekend long, and one of the greatest things is that on Fridays it's free. No cost to enter. Just get to the island and enjoy the day of family activities and thrilling races. Now back at Kowa Center, more intense competition takes place with the USA Taekwondo National Championships. This competition is tough, and the action is nonstop. It all starts on June 29th and ends on July 6th. So it's a great way to spend part of your Independence Day holiday. Would you like to maybe see some future Major League ball players? Well, you get your chance July 19th through the 23rd. Detroit is also the home of the AAU Junior Olympic Games. So if you want to watch a whole host of sporting events at one time, then this is your event. With so many competitions taking place, they're spread out at various venues across the city, but easy to get to. This prestigious event takes place July 26th to August 5th. Now, what's become a great tradition in the D is the Detroit Sports Commission Prep Kickoff Classic. This premier season-opening high school football event is eagerly anticipated every year as regional teams come together to play on the campus of Wayne State University. Kickoff starts on August 24th and goes until August 26th. Now, if fishing is your thing, there's no better place to be on August 24th through the 27th than taking in the Bass Elite Championship out on Lake St. Clair. Professionals hit what is known as one of the greatest bass fishing lakes in the country. The competition is fierce and the results exciting to watch. Plus, there's plenty of family activities to enjoy all weekend long. Now there's plenty more going on from spring until fall, and even more going on from fall until winter. But one thing's for sure, if you're looking for unique sporting events to enjoy with your family and friends, the D will always have what you're after.
Things are happening in Detroit that are going to reinvent the American city.
Those of us who have been here a long time can tell you that it's never been more vibrant.
And it really represents the future, what the future can be and what the future is becoming.
Let's start at 5 a.m. We have joggers that are running through our state park, that are running on the riverfront.
I kind of like that Detroit has its own vibe right now. Like, it's awesome to be Chicago and it's awesome to be New York, but we kind of have like this underdog thing going on.
Visitors come in from out of town and they absolutely adore the city of Detroit.
When they get here, what they see is different than what they've come to expect.
I've been all over the country, and downtown Detroit is as safe as anywhere I've been.
We have a lot of people, especially our generation, who are doing everything we can to build it up.
So in a way, it feels like being in a kind of lively college town in the middle of Detroit.
It's really a very compact downtown and a very exciting one because it has so much great architecture, great cultural institutions.
Lots of restaurants, coffee shops, walking, there's tours to do, there's museums to see, art.
We've got Campus Martius Park, one of the best urban parks in the United States.
The DIA, the cultural center.
We have a farmer's market.
It's easy to get from here to Campus Martius to Greektown, just walk all over the place.
The Fox Theater, the DAC.
There is so much to do in this city, and it's not like every other city.
All of us from downtown Detroit recognize that safety is the key to everything.
Come to Detroit and see for yourself.
You gotta see it to believe it.
Well, that's our show. Thanks for watching. I'm Veronica Vance. And remember, if you would like more information on any of the places we visited, log on to visitdetroit.com. So until I see you next time, go out and explore on your own and discover the D.
To learn about discounts and special offers for featured attractions, plus how to get copies of Visit Detroit magazine, click on visitdetroit.com.
Hang on, I gotta figure out how to turn it. Always something happening here. You never know what. Oh, hang on. Oh, how's that? Is that better? Keep watching it. Thank you.
Does that happen often?
No,
not usually. What I want to do, even to get more.